film is Heaven and Earth, and this is the first time I've really been disappointed by director Oliver Stone in a long time. I think this is a very sketchy, rough work with narration that merely states emotion, substituting for his usual dramatic intensity. As we follow the fortunes, as Roger mentioned, of a young Vietnamese woman during the American War in her country.
When the soldiers came, I fought to keep my village and my family from being torn apart.
We are the soldiers of liberation!
Hip T. Lee plays the woman, and her suffering during the war is tragic, of course, but nothing that is surprising on the screen. Not much better is when she is befriended by an American sergeant, Tommy Lee Jones, in his most predictable work in years.
Is this your little brother?
What?
Is this handsome little boy your relative?
My son.
Oh, of course he is. He looks just like you. A lot of spirit around the eyes.
The film does break out of familiar territory when Jones's tour of duty is over and he and his growing family come back to an America that we get to view through a foreigner's eyes. Here's where director Stone shines for the first time in this film.
You know, the first thing the old men and the old women would say to us, please, sir, don't kill me. In Da Nang, we drive past these hospitals, past people our bombs had blown to bits, and they'd wave. Boys and girls with no arms, no legs, waving at us like goddamn tourists on the way to the beach. Why? Because they're happy to be alive. They're glad to see us. And we put them where they were. And there's 20 of them, dead or mutilated, for every one of us. So don't expect Lee to do handstands over your goddamn turkey. She knows exactly what she's got. And she knows what she's left behind.
Some of those scenes are very good. I appreciate that Oliver Stone gives us the Vietnamese view of the war, a point of view not represented previously in Hollywood war films. But again, we're told how bad things are in narration and not in original scenes, save for a few of the American passages. Sorry to say, but you won't be surprised very often by Heaven and Earth.
Well, all I'm surprised by is your review. There's very little narration in this film, Gene, and there are a great many dramatic scenes
the beginning,
that show
she
the life of this woman as she
narrates
is
her
off. Well, sure, she talks to us a little bit at the beginning, but what about the dramatic scenes where she's dealing with the Viet Cong and they're dealing with her and they're assaulting her?
I was never to understand why I was raped and not killed. Or if I had ever really been sentenced by the Viet Cong. It may have just been a warning to my father. But it ended forever. My relationship to my village.
I guess I didn't think that those were anything that I hadn't sort of seen before.
I don't think you've seen
prisoner of
anything
war
like
stuff
that before.
Films.
One of the things that this movie really, I think, emphasizes is the fact that while trying to win the hearts and minds of these people, we took them off of their land, put them into so-called strategic hamlets, so that they had to leave the places that their ancestors had made sacred. And this was why we could basically never win the war. And then it shows the whole dynamic that brings her to Saigon and gets her involved in the sex industry. That isn't done with a lot of narration.
No, the stuff that you just said, bring her to Saigon with the sex industry, that I think viewers of Vietnamese war films certainly have heard that story.
Well, you know, there's only one war. I mean, he can't make up a new war with original stuff in it. What he's doing here is for the first time showing that war through the eyes of a Vietnamese woman whose life was totally disrupted by it.
The only part that surprised me, the only thing where I saw something fresh is when she got to America.
Well, I saw a lot more than that.
For your casserole tonight, we are featuring the 8-ounce canned Spam.
I think we need to go back to aisle 3 when that cute guy is.
He makes a cute snack.